Welcome to C programming class. In this video, I will cover string functions in C program. In previous video, I covered basics of string. Please go through that video. After watching this video, you can continue with this lecture. So now, string functions. Sometimes we use that word string manipulation function. So these are inbuilt functions. It's already defined by string header file. The first function I will take, string len, strlen. Okay, this function is used to find the length of the string, how many characters in string excluding null character. For example, if I write one string Kundapura, in Kundapura I have 9 characters. If I use string length function, it will give value 9. It counts the number of characters in the given string. We'll see. Now this is a syntax or example. We can consider it example. Here I need one integer variable, that is length, or you can give any name, length, count, anything. Okay, and strlen inbuilt function, it is inbuilt function. Okay, it's library function already defined, and we need to pass string. So str is any string. If I pass any string inside the strlen function, string len function, then it will count the number of characters in that string, and that value will be assigned to len. When we display len, it will give the count. Okay, we'll see through the through example, easily we'll understand. Here length, any integer variable, and str is any string. Like that, we have another function sizeof, because so note down the difference between strlen and sizeof. Sometimes we use sizeof as an operator. So sizeof is function, it's defined in string. And sizeof is used to determine the size of declared string. That means total memory allocated in bytes. Okay, sizeof will give how many locations allocated. Okay, it will give the memory size. String len will give the number of character in the string. Okay, so we will see the example. Easily you will understand the concept. And note down one more thing. When we use string len sizeof, not size of, when we use string len or any string functions in C program, so don't forget to use header file string.h, because all the features defined in header file string.h, like hash include stdio.h, you need to add one more statement, hash include string.h, because all the features of this function defined in string.h header file. Example, hash include stdio.h. This is a basic header file required to execute C program. Along with this, we need one more header file, string.h, because strlen or any string functions defined inside the string.h header file. Okay, now int main, I'll declare one string. The name of string is str. You can give any name. Here I have taken string name str, and how many locations are there? 7 locations are there, and I initialize mitk. So what is my string here? My string is mitk. I initialize to array str. Okay. I need one variable length. Okay. That is integer variable. See here. Strlen. Now this is already defined. It will count the strlen, and I passed str. So name of the array. I passed that str. So now strlen count the characters in string, which is mitk. Okay, what is the value of str? Initial value of str is mitk. So mitk is a string. So how many characters are there? 4 characters are there. So now strlen count the number of characters. So it will give 4, and that 4 will be assigned to length. 4 is the number. That's why we need integer variable. That 4 will be assigned to length. So what is the value of length now? It is 4. When we display length, our output will be 4. String length is %d, that is 4. So your output will be 4. So we'll see that later. Next, here I'll display size. Size of string is %d. Here what I used, size of. Here directly I have used function size of. Size of is an inbuilt function. Size of str. Size of str. I passed that str. What is str? Now this is str. Str will give value 7. What is the output of previous statement? 4. So strlen. Strlen will give the number of characters. Size of will give memory allocated. How many locations allocated? 7. So output of this statement will be 7. See here. How many locations are there? 7 locations are there. But I used 4 locations to store mitk. Remaining will be null characters. Here number of characters in my string 4. But size allocated to that string is 7. Size of will give size or number of location, and string length will give number of characters. Length of the character. Length, when I trace the first statement, your memory will be allocated like this. What is the value of length now? So we don't know, some garbage value. After executing this statement, string length, right hand side part will count the characters. So that is 4. The 4 will be assigned to length. After that, length value will become 4. So when we display, string length is 4 and size of string is 7. Size of function will give the total memory allocated to that string, that is 7, and string length will give number of characters or count of the given string, that is 4. Again, one more string manipulation function, string copy. See, string copy. This function is used to copy the contents of one string to another string. So that means we need to pass two array, character type array here. So now DEST, you can give any name. So DEST means it's a destination string. SRC is a array, it is source string. String copy function is used to copy all the contents of source string to destination string. Okay, we'll see through example to understand in better way. Int main. Here I have two array of character. The first one is SRC, size is 5. Next, mitk. I initialize to source. MITK is initial value of source, but we don't have any value to destination. Now I need to transfer MITK to destination. Already MITK in source. Now my string copy function should transfer that MITK to destination array. Directly I will use the string copy function, which is already defined. Here I passed two arguments. So now these src and destination as argument I passed to string copy function. Src content will be copied to destination. So dest, okay, just not I. Okay, we should write same as what we declared in the beginning. Next, printf destination string. If I display destination string dest, so it should give output MITK. See here, initially we had values to src, not to destination. After using string copy function, content of src is transferred to dest, dest. Okay, here not dest. Okay, you just neglect this I. Okay, dest. So typing error, dest, dest. Okay, so when we display dest, your output will be MITK. See what is the content of src MITK. What is the content of dst? We don't have any value. After executing string copy function, the content of destination will be MITK. Now we can display destination string and output will be MITK. Next, string copy function. Here you can find three arguments. I pass destination string, source string, and also n. So is n will give number of characters. How many characters we need to transfer from one array to another array? For example, in previous case, it will copy all the contents of the array. Okay. Sometimes, if I want to copy only two characters, then I should use strn copy string strn cpy function. You'll see the example destination string, source string. N is the number of characters to be copied into the destination string. Strn cpy function is used to copy n characters of the source string to destination string. Example, I'll move fast, you will understand easily. Content of src is MITK and destination string, we don't have any value. We need to transfer some content of src to destination. Okay, here I use strncpy. I will not copy all the characters, I will copy only three characters. And what would be the output? I display both, source string is MITK. If I display destination string, then we'll see what output we'll get. So what is the content of src? MITK. I initialize to MITK. What is the content of destination? We don't have any value. After executing strncpy, in this function I will copy only three characters, MIT. And it will not copy k, because here I passed variable 3. If I pass 2, it will copy only mi. If I pass 1, it will copy only m. See here, I have two printf. First, I'll printf content of source. If I display source string content, output will be MITK. If I display content of dest, then it will be MIT. I hope you understood this function. Next, another function, str cat, string concatenation function. It will combine the two string, or it will merge the two string. Str1 is first string, str2 is second string. Strcat, string concatenation function. Strcat function is used to concat or combine two strings. The function copies all the characters of string str2 to the end of str, end of the string str1. We'll see through the example. I have two string, str1, hello, and destination string mitk. In both array I have value. Now I need to combine that to string. So my output should be hello mitk. Now I have two different strings. After combining two string, it will generate single string. What will be the output? Hello mitk. So who will combine this two string? Strcat function. This is inbuilt function. Nothing to do here. You just use that function by passing these two array, str1, and so here I have used destination str2. Okay, I'll change that. Typing error. I have two array, str1 and str2. Content of str1 is hello, content of str2 is mitk. After combining, our output should be hello mitk. So string concaten function, concatenation function will combine str1 and str2. Combine string is str1 hello. Okay, now after using strcat function, content of mitk will be transferred to str1, and here that null character will be replaced by first character of second string. So your output will be like this, hello mitk. So here, after displaying str1 here, is not str2, your output will be hello mitk. Combine string is hello mitk. Just change that str1. Okay, I hope you understood the concept of string. So things to be noted here. We need to add header file string.h when we use string function. Else it will give error, because all the features of the string functions added in header file string.h. Okay, in next video I'll cover some complex example, and it will not be asked in exam. If you cover these concepts in clearly, That's enough. Just go through the both video of string and you will understand clear concept. Okay, so thank you.